May the Lord's richest blessings be with each and every one of us. As Brother Suresh Kumar just now announced, I have come day for yesterday from Brazil, and I visited many churches there. Our brethren, from there, they conveyed their greetings and love to the brothers in Roanoke Church. I am so happy to convey their love and greetings to you here this morning. I would like to see how many of you are so happy to receive the greetings from them. May God bless us. And day after tomorrow, I am leaving from here to Asia. When I go there, how many of you are happy to send your greetings to brethren in Asia? I would like to see. May God bless you, brethren. You are God's people. When you say something, God will listen. I cannot speak to God. I have to contact God through you. If you are not there, I cannot speak to God. This is the concept of Hindus. There are priests. Only they could speak to God. They have a special language. In that they have to speak to God. If an ordinary man, if he speaks to God, God cannot understand. God will not respond. This is the concept of Hindus. But this concept entered into a Christian church in the East. Especially, I would like to say something about a church which is in Velankanni, in India, Roman Catholic Church. That church is considered as common to every religion. The Hindus go there and they sacrifice animals and worship there. And the Christians go there, they kneel down and pray and go. And everybody can enter there and worship. There, the people used to tell the priests, you are God's people. You can speak to God. If we need something, we have to come to you. Through your mercy, I can contact my God. This is what the concept they have. I heard. But I would like to know, how many of us are having a similar concept within ourselves? When we come out, we will say, yes, it is my God. I can talk to him. I am son of God. I have that privilege that I can talk to him. But inner feeling I am talking about. Because I know about myself. Sometimes I may feel that, see, I have been doing this. I don't think that I am eligible to call God and say to him. Even if I call, I don't think that God is going to listen to me because I am a wicked. I am a sinner. And I have been keep on doing unwanted things. So therefore, I don't think that I will enter into heaven. Heaven is not for me. And I cannot communicate God directly because I am wicked. That concept, sometimes it may poke inside. This morning, we are going to see who are God's people, how we can contact him in order to listen our prayers. In order to hear our prayers, what are the prerequisites God brings to our attention? We are going to see that. As we were reading this morning for the scripture, I would like to turn to the same chapter, same book, 2 Chronicles, chapter 7, verse 14. If my people, which are called by my name, shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven and will forgive their sin and will heal their land. My people, God says, He says, my people, you know, when we say, this is my son, you know what affection we could see in that while he is saying or introducing somebody, this is my son, this is my daughter. But at the same time, if somebody is with them, and how we will say, this is my brother's son. You see, the tone will change. When we say my son and my daughter, more emphasis will be there. Whereas when we say this is my brother's son, so the tone will go little lower. Why? That relationship, the close relationship with the son, the father-son relationship, that makes them to emphasize that, saying that this is my son. When God says my people, He really means that we are His people. We are His people. How? How can we say that we are His people? And what God says in order to say or prove that we are His people, if you turn to the book 1 Peter, chapter 2, verse 9, here it says, but ye are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, and a holy nation, a peculiar people, that you should show forth the praises of Him who hath called you out of darkness into His marvelous light. You know what God calls now? Ye are chosen generation. All true Christians belong to that generation. They all make one family. We are distinct from the common world. We are called by God from that world. We are chosen in Christ to be such and sanctified by Holy Spirit. We are His people. When God says, my people, this is what He says. He has called us. He has selected us. So, all true servants of Christ are royal priesthood. We are royal in our relation to God. We are royal in our relation to Christ. We are princely in the improvements and the excellency of our own spirit and in our own hopes and expectations. We are separated from sin. We are separated from sinners. That is why God calls my people. We are proud of being His people. We are consecrated to God. We offer spiritual services to God and acceptable to God through Jesus Christ. A special people. Here it says holy nation. A holy nation. We are composed as one holy nation. We are collected under one head, agreeing the same manner and agreeing the same customs. We have our Christian manners, our Christian customs. We belong to that. Therefore, we are God's people. These are the identifications in order to show that we are God's people, in order to proclaim that we are God's people. Identification marks. The characteristics will be counted towards it. The world may say so many things. Among the Hindus, when we go, Christians are lower class. Even in those days, they were counted as untouchables. Even today, the same concept is existing among Hindus. The Christians are lower class people. Then who are the higher class? The priest, which I told you just now, that they could contact God, they can speak to God. They are higher class. And one, two, three, four classes. The last class is the lower class. Christians belong to that class. We cannot blame them because they don't know what we are. They don't know. Even if you go and say that we belong to God, they don't understand. Therefore, they won't accept. But we belong to, are composed as one holy nation. We are governed by the same law. We are consecrated and devoted to God. We are renewed and sanctified by Holy Spirit. And again, when we see here, it says, we are a peculiar people. We are not ordinary. We are God's peculiar people. We are people of His choice. He called us. He selected us. It is not we go and join. He selected us. So we are people of His choice. We are people of His care. And we are people of His delight. Precious people. Because God has selected us to consider them, to call them as His people. Therefore, He says, my people. He is not saying the whole world, my people. Because He created, but He created. But out of this world, He has selected. He has called. So we are special people. We are effectually called out of the darkness into the state of marvelous light, into the state of joy, pleasure, and prosperity. God gives. God blesses. He is taking care of us. By seeing us, He is so much joy. He is delighted. How? When we see our children, while they are coming, you know how happy we are. Whatever we have, we throw it and go and take the child. Why? Because we love. By seeing that child, we are so much delighted. And we take, and we kiss. But we will not see where his face, where his leg. We will kiss from top to bottom. Why? Because we love them. The same way Father loves us by saying, my people. The world is filled with people, but still he is not saying all my people. He says only the remnant one. And we are most valuable in the world. We should show forth by our deeds and our words that we have to meet the expectation of the Lord. He has called us, but he has a great expectation on us. How are we going to meet? What are the expectations? We will see. Let us go to the book of Deuteronomy. Chapter 7, verse 6. For thou art a holy people unto the Lord thy God. The Lord thy God hath chosen thee to be a special people unto himself, above all people that are upon the face of the earth. Upon the face of the earth, many people. But what? God has chosen thee to be a special people unto himself. We are God's people. God has chosen us. And when we go back to the 2 Chronicles 7th chapter, verse 14, it says, if my people, which are called by my name, what is the name of God? He says, my name. When we turn to the book of Jeremiah, chapter 23, verse 6. In his days Judah shall be saved, and Israel shall dwell safely. And this is his name, whereby he shall be called the Lord of our righteousness. He is our righteousness. The name of God is righteousness. He is a sovereign. He is all-sufficient. He is eternal. He is righteous. All our righteousness has its being from him. And by him it subsists, and we are made the righteous of God in him. Because he is righteous. When we follow him, when we have the characteristics of the characteristics which are expected by God, then that righteousness is given to us. We are righteous. How? We are made the righteous of God in him. This is the name whereby he shall be called. God shall call him by his name, by this name, for he shall appoint him to be our righteousness. By this name, every true believer shall call him. Through this, we are justified before God. So he is righteous. So which are called by my name shall humble themselves. Here he gives his expectation. In order to become his people, what are the expectations on us? First one here, shall humble themselves. Humble themselves. We should humble ourselves daily before God. The Christian service, page 247. He says we should humble ourselves daily before God. Not feel that our wisdom is perfect. We should not feel that I know everything. I can do this one. I don't need anybody's help. So I know that ego should not work there. That we have to keep aside. Even burn it and throw. But we have to humble ourselves. It is true. The people, those who are not having anything, they will stand straight. But when we have something, we have to bow our head down. That humbleness, that shows the maturity of a man. We should not pray for God to humble us. God, I want to humble myself. You please help me. It is not. We have to ask God to humble ourselves. Whereas what we have to do? When God takes hold of us, He will humble us. So we have to yield ourselves to Him. We have to yield our will to His will. When we become His, when we accept Him, when we ourselves surrender unto Him, He will make us humble. It is not directly we have to ask God, please make me humble. It is impossible. We must day by day humble ourselves under the mighty hand of God. The same Christian service, page 247. We must day by day humble ourselves under the mighty hand of God. We have to humble ourselves. Always we must bow our head and see ourselves down. I was sitting in my outhouse, which was very small, only one door, and I was just sleeping, and the door was little bit opened. So a bird, which straight came inside and sat on my cot, and then it was looking up. She picked something down, and then it came again to the cot, and it was sitting there and looking up, and it was trying to go out. It was flying again and again upward. The bird is not at all looking down. It was flying up, it go and hit there and come down and sit, again go in the another corner, hit and come down and sit. It was trying to find a way to go out. I was just noticing that one. And then I myself felt that I have to say something to that bird. I said, why don't you go down here? The door is opened. Why don't you go through the door? Why you are trying there? It was again the same thing. It got tired. It got hard breath. Because it was up and down. It was flying and falling down. And then I don't think that the bird felt, who asked you to say that one? I know how to go. You don't need to say anything. So this is the way I felt. I think the bird doesn't like myself speaking to the bird. Okay, let it go, whatever the way it wants. Then it was up and down, and finally he fell down. After falling down, just he opened the eyes and saw the door was open. And then what happened? How the bird regained the strength, immediately jumped and flew away. Free. What the bird was expecting was freedom from the bondage. Somehow by mistake, knowing or unknowing, it got inside. But the attitude is always up to go. But I was thinking about how many men are like that. They are thinking always up. That means I am not talking about heaven. I'm talking about their attitude, thinking that they are up always. They never bow their head down in any situation. So we should not be like that. We must be very humble. Very humble. I was teaching Sabbath school when I was working in university. There were more than 300 people were sitting. And I was standing under the tree and I was just shouting and I was teaching to them. And I asked a question. If a Christian life was to be described under the figure of a locomotive, which part would you rather be? This is what the question I asked. In that locomotive, if it is a Christian life, you will become what part of that locomotive? I asked that question. One girl got up and said, I will become a whistle of that locomotive. I asked why. No, I will blow the gospel message to the world. I said, okay, good for your thinking. It is very good. And another man, he got up and said, I will become a bell. I asked why. To warn the soul of danger which is going to come. Okay. As far as you are concerned, it is good. And then another person got up and said, I will become a coupler. That means I will join churches together. He was thinking reasonably. I said, okay. And this time, one brother got up. Usually he never opens his mouth. We used to tell him he is a brother, Mr. Silence. And he slowly got up and asked, yes, brother, what part you would to be like? And he said, and it was a long time I was keep on asking, yes, brother, tell. And finally he said, I would be a black coal thrown into the furnace, and there I burn for the glory of God. I want to become a black coal so that they can take and throw into the burners. So there I will burn myself for the glory of God. This is what the answer. When I heard that answer, I could not believe myself. Honestly, I tell you, I cried. I could not further conduct my class. The all people were sitting astonished. What a wonderful answer that is. He feels that he has to sacrifice himself for the cause of God. He says, I will burn there in order to glorify God. You know how much he is humble and simple in Christ. That we must be very humble. This is what God says for my people. What he says, shall humble themselves. That is the first character, first qualification. In order to identify ourselves that we are God's people. Humble ourselves. This is what the lesson from the beginning till end Jesus Christ was teaching to us. But how far we understood about the ministry of his, the earthly ministry of Christ. How far we are becoming humble and humbler every day, day by day. It is a state of mind, well pleasing God. We must become humble. It preserves the soul in tranquility. It makes us patient under trial, the humbleness. Prosperity ruined the people because they forget to be humble. The more money they get, the more firm and firm they get, they forget God. The humbleness will not be in them. But we are very rich. We are children of God. But we have to follow Christ and learn humbleness from Him. And when we read a little more further, it says, humble themselves and pray. This is another characteristic. Pray. It is not like chanting mantras. It is a contact between Father and Son. Communication between Father and Son. Placing request of the Son to Father. We have to pray. Humbleness can make soul strong to resist temptation. Whereas prayer, it brings what we need from God. At the same time, when we have self-confidence, it leads to neglect the prayer. We feel, I can do it. Who is going to ask? Nobody can come in between. Such kind of self-confidence. If it is there, then we may neglect prayer. Make it sure that if we neglect prayers in our life, at home, or wherever we go, that we are very sure that you have a self-confidence. You are forming that character within yourself. Trusting and making your wants known to God is prayer. We trust, if I ask, may God will give. But how I am going to reveal my ambition, my need? Ask God through prayer. He reveals His power and wisdom in answer to humble prayer. Ministry of Healing, page 199. Have confidence in Him. Always we must have that. As prayer hearing and prayer answering God. He is our God, our Father. Prayer hearing God. Prayer answering God. I am a son of that God. That confidence we must have first. Those who devote time for meditating, prayer, and study scriptures will be connected with heaven. You see, we have communication, we have a connection between heaven and ourselves. That is prayer. Prayer is essential as a daily food. If we are missing one food, how much we are struggling? That struggle we must have when we miss prayers. Oh, afternoon I didn't pray yet. No, first I will go and pray and come back. That attitude we must form within ourselves. Because we are God's people. We belong to His family. He says, my people. That second character is prayer. Begin your day with prayer. Morning and evening as thanks offering to God. Prayer. Child training requires prayer. Again, at home, if we pray, children will be with us. You know, I have seen in one house, the child was adamant, crying. They were giving so many things, not accepting that. And he expected something from parents, but it was not available. It was keep on crying. So I saw mother is going and whispering something to husband's ears. And after whispering, he came and the husband got ready. Okay, come, let us all have a word of prayer. That child stopped crying and came and knelt down. You see how much the child is having a habit of prayer. He was crying. They were giving so many things they never accepted. That child never accepted. But when father said, come, let us have a word of prayer, ran and knelt down and ready for prayer. That way, child training requires prayer. Faith is strengthened by prayer. That is why God says that is a prerequisite. Humble yourself and prayer. Let nothing divert you from prayer. Heart glowing with God's love will offer prayer. Seek to know God through prayer. Seek counsel from Christ through prayer. So let us pray earnestly. And next when we come, further it says, and seek my face. Seek my face. What does it mean? When we read Genesis 3:8, there we could see Adam and Eve were hiding themselves from the presence of God. When we read Revised Standard Version, there it says, from the face of God. Here, seeking God's face is seeking God's presence. We have to seek the presence of God. We have to seek. We have to long. While we are longing to have ambition of seeing the face of Christ. That is what here it says. We have to long. We must long to see the face of Christ. You know, when I was working in Sweden as a coal porter 20 years back, my son was so small. And my wife used to phone to me saying that this fellow is not eating for the past 4 days. I asked why. Because he wanted to see you. He is crying. He is not eating. 4 days he is not eating. He wanted to see you. He wanted to see your face. I said, how can I come? You give the telephone to him. So I was talking to him. He said, Dad, I want to see you. Don't worry, mommy is there, our uncle is there. You please be with them. I will be. No, I don't want them. I want you. I want to see you. Why? He is longing to see me. The same way, we have to long to see the face of God, the presence of God. That longing, if we are having within ourselves, we are fulfilling one prerequisite. To see God's face is to have access to Him and to enjoy His favor. And another thing, I think time has gone. And turn from their wicked ways, the fourth expectation. Turn from their wicked ways. Wickedness existing in the world today, everywhere. It exists in high places. It is increasing among God's people. Why? They are living in the world. That wickedness is influencing God's people now because the last days. Humanity has become an instrument of wickedness today. Life is inheritance of righteous, but death is portion of wicked. Therefore, we have to look for the righteous way. Get away from the wickedness. For that, what we have to do? We have to turn away from that. When we take the book of James, chapter 4, verse 4, know ye not that the friendship of the world is enmity with God? Whosoever therefore will be friend of the world is the enemy of God. If we have little interest on this world, then we will become enemy of God. When we have interest in this world, then God cannot call us my people. Because we are of the world. We are not of God. So therefore, God says the fourth prerequisite. Away from wickedness. So when we meet all these prerequisites, you know what God says again? Then, if you meet all these, then will I hear from heaven and will forgive their sin. If you meet all four, then he will hear from heaven and he will forgive our sins. We will become his people. He will become our God. The relationship strengthened. It maintained day by day. We will become of him. And now mine eyes shall be open, and mine ears attend unto the prayer that is made in this place. For now have I chosen and sanctified this house, that my name may be there forever. And mine eyes and mine heart shall be there perpetually. So God promises so many things. But his expectation is meeting these four prerequisites. God expects that his people who are called by his name, if they have dishonored his name by their iniquity, should honor it by accepting the punishment of their iniquity. They must be humble themselves under his hand, must pray for the removal of the judgment, must seek and favor of God, and yet all will not do unless turn from the wicked ways and return to God. Mercy is then promised that God will forgive their sins, which brought judgment upon them, heal them. So God has promised many things, but before he asks something, in order to give something, he expects something. That is nothing but the Christian characters. When you have that characters, then God is so happy saying that, my people. Do we become his people? Do we have these characters within ourselves? Not only having that put into practice in our day-to-day life in order to show that we are his people. in order to identify ourselves to the world that we are his people. Let us have those characters. Let us have. What he is asking? Shall humble themselves, pray, seek my face, turn from their wicked ways. When we follow this, God's abundant blessing will be with us. The relationship is maintained, strengthened. The more we depend on him, he gives more strength, more wisdom. When we have that in the family, there will be peace, there will be joy and happiness. Not only that, more hope, and we will have more expectation that we will enter into that kingdom. We are very sure that I belong to God. That is my Father's property. I will go on inherit that because I live as his son. I live as his daughter. God says, my people, I belong to that category. So let us say, let us hope, let us try to follow these characters in order to make ourselves his people. May God bless us. Amen. And living Father which art in heaven, we thank thee, Lord, for all the blessings that thou hast bestowed upon us. We thank thee, Lord, for the day in which we are glorifying thy name. Thank thee, Lord, for bringing us together to thy sanctuary where we could learn of thee and accept thee and glorify thy name through our programs and activities. Thank thee for this golden opportunity to join together and hear thy word as a spiritual food. When we enter in our Lord, we were having our heart wide open, but now we feel we are filled with the food which offered by thee. With the full satisfaction, let us go from here. Thank the Lord for the message which thou art brought to us for our attention. We are proud of saying that we are God's people. We accept and enjoy from thy mouth saying, they are my people. We belong to that. What a wonderful opportunity we are having. Thou art called us, selected us, and blessing us, and keeping up for a noble cause. Thank the Lord. Give us more and more opportunity so that we can carry thy message to the world. We can advocate thy principles and propagate thy message to the world which is in darkness. Our Lord, thank thee for giving us the characteristics which we ought to have in our life in order to say that we belong to God's family. From today on, we are going to keep in our life those characters so we can make ourselves happy, joy and satisfaction of thinking that we belong to God. Be with us. Bless our ministers and bless the ministry which is going on around the world. Be with them, bless them. Let them also feel that they belong to the family of God. And let them go and work. Give thy wisdom to them. Give thy power to them. So that they can enter into nook and corners of the world in order to carry thy message. Let them show Jesus Christ to the world. So that Jesus will expel the darkness from the world. So everybody can see the light and come closer to him. Be with us. Bless us. Guide us, finally save us in the eternal kingdom. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen.